no problem with that. But oftentimes, if you're not careful, due to the homes that many of these females are raised in, they will try, if you allow it, they'll try to see if they can treat you how they treated their little brother or how they saw their mother treat their male siblings, which to reduce you to the status of a young boy. And that's where you have to pump the brakes. That's where you have to declare the line of demarcation. And you tell that female you do not cross over that line. If you try that again, it's not going to work out well for you. And if she does not tolerate that, cool. She's doing you a favor. You have a wonderful day. Brothers, let me tell you this. Females who don't know how to conduct themselves, eventually they're forced to face that reality. It doesn't matter if they resist it with you or with the next guy or the guy after that. Once something is over, you cut your losses and you move forward. Don't carry that baggage your whole life. 99% of the females in this society, in the westernized society, are not worth much. Are there exceptions to the rule? Absolutely. There are some good females out there. If you're a good man, you'll know how to pick and choose them. They are out there, just like there are needles in haystacks. But you can't carry that baggage around with you your whole life. Whatever has been done to you, you have to let it go.
She made you.
Yeah, she made me.
I guess she had something to prove.
She made you.
Yeah.
What she say she was doing if you didn't do it?
She was gonna kick me out.
There you go. That's what happens when you're not providing for yourself. That's what happens when the female sees that you don't exhibit manly traits. She's gonna let you know, either you're going to declare to the world that you're my bitch, or you're gonna be out there on the street. Brothers, there's very few people that we're going to encounter in life that are going to treat you well just off of general principles. Overall, interactions between yourself and someone else is going to be based on the concept of quid pro quo, this for that. I mean, that's why I stated, I deduced that this guy's looking for his mother. He's looking for someone who's going to tell him, it's okay, baby. I believes in you, baby. I'm gonna cook some breakfast for you, baby. I'll let you stay in the basement, baby. That's what this guy's looking for.
You didn't have your own place.
I was living with her. And then I moved out and lived with her.
That's how you know his mind was already working on who he was going to move on to once he was placed in the predicament where he was going to actually have to follow through with the wedding. This was a hustle from the very beginning.
Why you keep living with all these women?
Because he's a bitch.
You can't get your own place?
Oh, I got one now. Sure.
What?
Yeah, you finally learned.
What, this one threw you out of my
house? Oh, no, I left her.
You left her?
Oh, yeah.
Why?
She was kind of crazy.
Hey, well, that's going to be the average female in this society. So at least you learned, brother. Good for you. Get rid of that bitch energy. Get rid of those bitch antics. Get your own place and work on your own dream.
You didn't know that when you put that? I'm glad you have your own place now, but hopefully you have enough left to pay her rent if she proves her case. How does he owe you, ma'am?
Okay, so originally when he left, he told me that he was going to pay me the rent. He only
for
the rest of our lease. Our lease was going to be up in September. So
he left when?
He left the end of May, beginning of June, kind of. Mm-hmm. So we still had June, July, August, mm-hmm. and then the prorated rent of September.
Okay.
He gave me $300 the week of June, told me that's all he could afford right now, and that he wasn't paying me any more of the rent.
All right, sir, what do you say to this?
Before I left, we had a verbal agreement that she would take over the lease of whatever was left after I left.
Now, brothers, did you hear what he stated? He said before he left, they had a verbal agreement. There's no such thing as a verbal agreement with a woman. Beyond that, hell, there's no such thing as a verbal agreement in this society today with a man, because most men are not men of their word. There's no such thing as a verbal agreement. Get everything in writing or over text message or email or what have you. There is no such thing as a verbal agreement, especially with a modern day female.
So I gave her the money that was needed after I left in May.
Needed for when?
For May, for the month of May.
Okay, and she said she'd take over 100% the remaining months.
Yes.
Why do you think she changed her mind?
Because she saw that stuff on social media.
Yeah, that's part of it. Also, she's broke as a joke.
And got jealous.
Ma'am, did you ever tell him you'd take care of all of
it? No.
What's your emotional distress for?
For one, I had to work extra hours at work, working 8 a.m. to 10 p.m. just to pay the rest of the rent that he couldn't pay.
Now, brothers, did you hear that? That's why I stated that the reason why she moved him in so fast wasn't just because she was lonely and she wanted a man and she wanted to be married for a status symbol, but she also needed help financially. Brothers, a lot of these broads are broke as a fucking joke. Run all around the internet trying to start arguments. You know why? Because feminism has not worked out for them. Please understand something. This society tries to hustle to you that marriage is about falling in love. That's not what marriage is about. That's never been what it's about. Marriage was always about a convention to maintain the life of a woman by passing her from her father to her husband. That's what marriage was set up for. It was not set up for being in love. So there's really nothing wrong with a woman wanting to be married so that she has financial support. But at the same time, she's supposed to understand the hierarchy in the family unit is the man as the head. So before you decide to marry a woman, always understand that it's up to you to establish the conduct of the woman in adverse situations. How does she respond to adversity? How does she react when things are getting tough, getting bad? These are all things that you have to know beforehand, before you make that level of commitment, whether it's contractual or not.
Also, emotional stress because I have